Tuesday, London Outlook, August 11th, 2009. Welcome to FX Bootcamp. Quick reminder, FX Bootcamp is not an alert service, not going to make any trade recommendations during the course of a day. However, what I will do is conduct some live fundamental and technical analysis, hopefully help you put together some good positive trade plans. Bear in mind that when you're trading heavily leveraged, occasionally this leverage will work for you. Unfortunately, more times than not, as a novice trader, it has a horrible way of working against you. So please do not trade real money until you have a good proven track record of success using a demo account. Okay, folks, well, today I think I'm going to take a quick look here at the Aussie dollar and maybe some pound yen, and we'll call it good, okay? We got obvious themes in the market right now, a little bit of equities weakness, and that's lent itself to some fairly considerable dollar strength. Yesterday's euro trade worked out nicely. I got it wrong on the pound Swiss. We were not able to break that 180.80 resistance area, then broke below that 180.20, and it was pound weakness for the better part of the day. So, one for two on that one, not the best. So hopefully today we can come up with a couple of decent trade plans. Okay, this is the daily Aussie chart. Okay, been making a series of higher lows and higher highs on a daily level. All right, everything looks great to the upside. All right, one thing that's notable here is, how we've had a series of these. We've gone up, we've consolidated, we've gone up, we've consolidated, we've gone up, we've consolidated. Now, it's not common. It's very, very common to see, up, consolidation, up, and sometimes you'll get a third leg, which we've had here. So if we count this as one, two, and three. Now, I'm not an Elliott Wave trader by any means. That's not a criticism on Elliott Wave theory at all. I've just never really looked into it, quite frankly. So I'm not counting waves by any stretch of the imagination yet, but experience tells me that one, two, and three moves up after consolidation is about all you get at the most, all right? Typically, you'd only get one and two and then a significant retracement before continuation. Well, now we've had three of them, and we're consolidating again. Now, if I take you to the 4-hour, all right, and zoom you in, you'll notice on the 4-hour that we keep making, up until this point, we've had no problem making higher highs and higher lows. Well, look at what's happened, okay? We've come back down to our 21 EMA, bounce off it, lower high. Come back down to support visually here, bounced off it, lower high. Back down to support in the way of the 55, bounced off it, lower high. All right, so every attempt to make a higher high has failed. Now, of course, this could be nothing more than just a continuation trap, all right? I'm more inclined to believe that this is the start of a little bit of a roll over here myself. I mean, the fact that we keep getting, because no trend starts, I say trend, no price movement starts, you go bearish, neutral, bullish, or bullish, neutral, bearish, all right? It's very seldom that you're going to get the bullish, bearish, all right? And using this bullish, neutral, bearish model, that's more or less what's trying to happen here. Bullish, neutral, bearish. Okay, so you'll go from really slow to speeding up, then you'll cascade over the waterfall. All right, now I'm hoping that's going to happen. Now we've got to break a couple of key areas here. If I take you back to the daily, all right, I'm watching this 82.50 area to the downside as a first stop. It's also roughly the 21 EMA on the daily. And to go back to the 4-hour, this zone here at 83.30 has obviously been very tough and is really the key level to break. If I was watching this earlier on, I would have definitely, going to the hourly, definitely looked to short this, 50% here, add all these previous swing lows and things. That's a nice high quality setup. And, down should come, limited risk, stop above the 786, very limited risk with maximum profit exposure. But now conservatively going into London, going back to the 4-hour, when a situation where we're really looking for a break of this 83.30 area, shooting down to 82.40, 90 per potential trade, folks. Nothing fancy, it'll break, pull back, retest these previous swing lows, and then continuation. All right? So that's my little Aussie dollar trade plan. If we break 84 to the upside, I'm bullish, but I'd be very careful then of double tops and things. All right, anything's possible, but a clean break of 84, I'm looking for double top there. I'd be very wary of a whole bunch of continuation to the upside. It's just looking tired, quite frankly. Okay, the other currency I want to look at here is our little friend, the pound yen. All right, now we reversed our non-farm payroll rise from Friday. Surprising, but not. I mean, I think that the, you know, we had one of our boot campers mentioned yesterday that she was, a little bit concerned about the, call it the anti-correlation between, you know, typically you see pound yen, pound Swissy, pound dollar all moving, in a positively correlated direction. Well, on Friday we had, you know, the pound dollar heading down and pound yen heading up, all right, and it really was more about what the USD and the yen were doing respectively. Well, yesterday it was all about what the pound was doing, right? Pound was definitely the weaker currency, and it's weaker here through Asia to a certain extent. So, you know, given the fact that we've failed a high here again, and what effectively, okay, I think a clean break of this 159.40 is really going to see us heading down quite considerably. If I take it to the daily, this daily 21 here, just to zoom you in, this daily 21 EMA looks like the appropriate play, and that's around the 158.29. So still, you know, the better part of 150 pips to the downside. Honestly, what my preference would be here, you know, given this previous resistance, my preference would be here for us to bounce up and test, say, 160.60-ish, going back to the, I'll take you to the hourly here, you know, kind of going back to this 160.60, that's the hourly 21 EMA plus all these previous swing lows. You know, 160.60, 160.50, that would be my preference if Asia would take us up there. It just looks very bearish to me. And then short through there, looking for a break at the bottom off to that 158.20, which is the daily 21 EMA. All right. Unfortunately, it doesn't look like it's going to provide us with that opportunity going to the four-hour Bollinger Band wide open. You know, my preference is a bounce here, back to resistance, and then continuation down to these previous lows here around that 158 area. Okay. So that's my little pound yen trade plan. Preferably back to 160.50 to short. Alternatively, we're going to be in a situation where we break 159, looking for a little fib continuation down to the 158s and change. All right. My name is David Pegler. Pretty simple stuff here, folks. Good luck further today. Thanks for all the feedback, and please keep that coming, okay? It's always good to hear from you, folks. And if there's anything in particular that you're looking at, you want me to look at, by all means, comment on YouTube, the blog, or Daily FX. I'm more than happy to respond to them in further videos, okay? Good luck further, and I'll catch up with you tomorrow.